I normally don't cover folksy music on this channel, but the grouper belongs to my favorite contemporary artists. So today we have all gathered here to cherish her newest album called Shade. The title in itself is appropriate because Liz Harris, grouper's music, throws shade at all the other indie folk female performers. She doesn't go below a certain high level. Whatever she touches, it turns gold. When she launches a different moniker and drops a long drawn album, it still somehow makes my favorite top 5 albums of that year. In other words, we are blessed to live in the times when Liz Harris makes music. Spoken like a true fangirl, which I am. Because the saying, beauty lies in the eyes of beholder, is nowhere more true than in folk or ambient music. Music speaks directly to your emotion. With very few sounds, it either hits the right chords or it doesn't. It either makes you touched, charmed, petrified even, or you're bored, you don't like it. The progression, the climate simply don't scale with you. It's like you have this one favorite clothing store where you go and you know that you will find something that will fit you, simply because they make cuts this way. So this is grouper for me, and as I know, also for many other people. Another thing that decides the rating is your own mood. With highly emotional music, you can appreciate artistic value, but you wouldn't have emotional connection because of your own stage in life. I'm afraid this might be a bit of my case with Shade. I know if I was listening to it alone at home or during my long flights that I used to take not a long time ago. Being alone, seeing different landscapes, attaching memories, activating specific parts of my brain, I would feel more personally connected. But right now I'm a bit busy, so I have less time and personal space than my basement soul would crave for. So this is the difference between the 8 and the 9 and the 10 for me. This is this difference with how the album resonates with me, and I believe it's the same for any of you. But back to Shade. The album starts with a distorted sound, which I guess is supposed to sound like an ocean, because this is the title of the song, Follow the Ocean. Far in the background there's a similarly distorted voice with unrecognizable with lyrics that are hard to recognize, which is typical for several of the of grouper's songs. She plays the mood and not the words. Here the mood of nostalgia makes you think like you're in one of these small British or American seaside towns that you would see in a British or American indie movie that would go to Sundance. The one with human drama and an open ending. We've all seen movies like that. They're all the same. Follow the Ocean is one of my two favorite tracks on this album. To be honest, I wish the whole album was like the first and the last song. However, the next track, Unclean Mind, already sets the spirits of Shade, which is a slow, sad, intimate melody with a guitar as the only instrument. Grouper uses instrument without any rush. You can hear the chords change, and even when she made a small mistake, like she hesitated a bit, she didn't cut it out. It's here and it sounds good. She builds the climate between her and the listener. It's delicate, haunting, but I wouldn't call it depressing. More like silent, poetic, reserved, but hopeful. I mean, she's definitely testing my knowledge of English adjectives. As I'm trying to express my feelings now when I'm recording this. Pale Interior is the prettiest song out of the ones that follow the opening track. It's the most focused and emotional. Disordered Minds is the second track where the drone takes the spot. This time it's more aggressive, like white noise, while the voice is almost completely covered by the sound of it. And to be honest, this is my favorite type of music that grouper makes. After that uneasy part, she sings a very pretty lullaby, the way her hair falls. The vocal of Liz is particularly beautiful in this one. It literally feels like she was improvising with this song. It adds to the charm. I mean, I feel like it's like her and me in the room and she's like improvising, inventing a new song to sing for me. Basement mix sounds like something that the goth folk would like. This song definitely doesn't have that soothing quality that the other ones do. It's nostalgic, but doesn't sound optimistic. It doesn't have this vibe that most songs here do. I mean, except of these drone songs. And finally, at the end, we're reaching Kelso, my second favorite song. The clear voice builds an atmosphere like you're going to the beach on a chilly day with a beautiful blue sky. And now this is the funny part, because this was my impression before I checked the song list, and I saw the second part of the title is actually Blue Sky. So I have interpreted it the way she wanted, so I think she did it in the correct way. And now I have trouble thinking how I would rate this album. Because if I was a producer or a person of her talent and I could do whatever I wanted with it, I'd start the album with the opening track, and I would make this type of thing go longer, and then I would calm the atmosphere with the track Pale Interior, and then I would go with Disordered Minds and keep going like that also. Because I think in that way, these slow songs are simply more rewarding. They make your mind easier after it's focused with following the drone. She saw it a different way, she reversed the proportions. She added more normal, simple songs. Of course, all of them are good songs. It's just that this way Shade sounds more like a collection of songs and less like an album. The way I'm proposing, it could be more difficult, more demanding, less understandable to a casual listener. I think it would be better though. Still, I have no doubts this is one of the best records we're going to get this year. So this is my rating. And well, I'll see you next time. In the next video, I'll try to revisit Otekara's Cornfield 20 years after it came out, and I'll see how it sounds now.